Hey everybody, how's it going there, man? Thanks again for tuning in to the old YouTube video. Appreciate you so much. I really enjoy making these YouTube videos right here. I get to connect with lots of people, and even some of them I have a tendency to help from time to time, and I'm so grateful for that. Okay, guys, I want to make a video today about a post I saw going through my news feed. I think I saw it yesterday and I made note of it, and I thought that would be a great idea for a video. And I'm just going to steal the title. It's the one thing that all successful people, leaders, religious leaders, people in the community, politicians all have in common that others may or may not have. Okay, we'll title it something like that when I get ready to title it. Okay, something that all those type of people have that others don't have, or something that they have that they've locked into, or they realize or they understand that they have, and they're aware of how to use it, in their life. Okay, and I want to talk to you about that. Okay, and we have such a huge shortage of it, guys. I'll just jump right in. Those type of people inspire people. They draw people to them with their language, with their body language, with their maybe they talk with their hands, or the purpose that they're serving in life, or their teachings, or stuff like that, or their success with their online or offline business. And the world needs more of that, I think. I think there's probably It's just in my humble opinion right here. There's probably maybe 100 to 1,000 obvious, popular, successful people, no matter what their background is or what their occupation is, online, offline, clergymen, clergywomen have that we all know. We all know the names. I'm not going to say the names. We all already know them. But I just think that there is just a shortage of those type of people around. And I'm making this video right now because I'm going to start working more and more on my personal development, not so much my business, but my personal development, so that when I connect with other potential marketers, potential people wanting to join me, I'll understand how to speak to them, how to connect with them on a certain level, and maybe how to be more attractive to them with my language and the way my posture, the way I come off to them. Okay, and let me tell you, I'm not going to make this a real long video. Let me show you what I've done. I thought, well, how in the world am I going to do that? I mean, I'm not really fantastic with the English language. I know a few words that I've learned on some webinars and some hangouts and stuff like that. And obviously, I've done a little bit of personal development and some reading, not as much as I should, but I thought to myself, I want to learn more about what it is I can do to give back to people. So I'll tell you what I did. And it's just one thing you can do. You can do lots of other things. Okay, and I've got another window open, so let's go there and jump there right now. Okay. Let's go up here right now, right quick. So what I did was, boom, there it is right there. Okay, so what I did was I went to Google and I Googled action words for successful people or professional profiles. And I thought, well, let me see what I come up with right there, right? And I came up with this right here. I come up with a lot of verbs, which are action words. Like love is an action word. You don't just tell your wife or your boyfriend or girlfriend you love them. You show them. You physically show them. Or maybe somebody outside your family, you give them a gift, or you whether it's a material gift or something you share that's very heartwarming to them, something they can use in their life, or something that gives them comfort. Okay, it's an action word to me when people are being inspiring like that. Verbs are action words. I even had to look that up because it's been a long time since I've been with English. Okay, so what I came up with was a list of action verbs for resumes and professional profiles. And there's a bunch of them, guys. There's like a bunch. And I thought I would make a list. Some of these words, and they're in alphabetical order or the categories that they're in, like teaching skills. I thought I might look in that section, right there, and see how I can improve on Mark Bosley's teaching skills. How can I improve on grooming people to come outside their shell and really bring out what they already have inside them? I mean, I think everybody has got leadership inside of them. I think it just needs to be brought out of them. And if they're connected with the right person who can bring that out in them, oh, I better scooch that up a little bit because that's where my face will be. Okay, let me scooch that up. Yeah, teaching skills right here. Yeah, my photo's probably in the way here. And this was a section I came up with. Let me go a little bit farther up. I'm sorry about that, guys. Those are some of the words I came up with. I'll scroll up a little farther so you can see it, you know, get it away from the picture. And then I can come back down. And you guys, I'll put the link in there so you guys can go and check it out. But I thought everybody has leadership ability in them, whether it's online, offline, football, baseball, car racing, horse racing, you know, how to be whatever in this world, how to be an architect. Everybody has some sort of leadership ability, some sort of leadership skills in their life, and they just need the right person or the right group of people to bring that out in them. Okay, and I thought that was part of a personal development area that I might work on my life this year, was to try and bring that out in people. And the reason I say that, there's a lot of people that come online in our industry and they join and they come on with enthusiasm, and then they're kind of an introvert when it comes to speaking to people like we're doing right now on this YouTube video or maybe on the telephone. They just shut down. It just, this wall goes up and then their success rate just goes to nothing, you know, or less than nothing. And then they get upset and they call you all sorts of names. But, and it's not their fault, and it could be my fault for not doing more for them in the way of teaching them to bring out their leadership skills in them, which I know that they already have. Okay. Obviously, there was something that stirred inside them that said, hey, I like this product or I like this service and I think I can do this. And then maybe they froze when they got in front of, or they were sending a message to somebody. So I need to work on my skills doing that so that that transition for them and for me, it goes smoother. Okay. It's about the word duplication, right? If I have an easy time talking to people, then I want to show others that join me how they can have an easy time talking to others and become a leader and posture themselves as a success story also. Okay, and that's really what I was going to try to focus on this year. Probably not going to do any new businesses. I like what I'm doing. My income seems to be working just fine. But I think if I refine more of my personal development skills in the way of communicating with people so that they can duplicate what I'm doing, you know, when they talk to people, that I'll be a better person and I can make them a better person too. And then maybe we can get in the category of those awesome people that are inspiring people out there every day. You know, you see them on TV and you see them on webinars and hangouts and stuff like that. And I'm always thinking, boy, I sure wish I had a crowd that big in front of me. And I think that that's doable if I just work on that, and I work on that by sharing that with other people. You know, I've heard a joke, you know, every week in my life, somebody tells me a great joke. And if I don't repeat that joke, I forget it. Okay, and it's just like some of your personal development. If you don't have anybody to work with, anybody to share it with, anybody to give it away to, then you'll forget it. Okay, so we can only keep what we have by giving it away, if you can understand that. Okay, and I use the joke as an example to, you know, hey, let me tell my buddy my joke, you know, and they'll get a big chuckle. Let me tell everybody what I've learned with my personal development, and that way my skills will begin to be refined and they can share what I shared with them, right? It's all about sifting, you know, through people and getting them to understand on a certain level, you know, maybe on a certain problem that you and them have together, and then moving forward from there. Okay, but I don't want to make this a long video, guys. I just wanted to, you know, let you know again, I was building a platform for what I was going to be doing for the 2017 upcoming year, and I'm already starting these videos out right now. In the motel right now, still enjoying myself, relaxing on vacation, and I'm getting ready to get back at it probably after the New Year's. But I'm going to be making the videos, and I'll throw them out there to you guys. And if you like them, if there's something I brought of value to you, you know, please like and comment, and you know, hit the big red button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And you know, if you want to talk to me, I'll leave my Facebook link in there. And We could connect right there on Facebook if you like. And if my business is something you're interested in, let's talk, let's communicate, let's have a conversation and see if this is something that I can help you with. Because that's what I'm going to work on this year is refining my skills, my communication skills, and my posturing skills with people so that I can be inspiring like those other successful stories. Okay. Guys, thank you for watching this video. And I'll leave that information in the description box below. Like, comment, and hit the big red subscribe button right there. I appreciate you, and I'll see you on the next video. Thank you. Bye-bye.